Hey there, so we talked about importing contacts in the last video, so now let's talk about exporting them. Over here in the top right, but below the import button, you'll see bulk actions and an option to export PSIDs. Now I want to note that there is actually a way for you to export information in a specific way to a Google Sheet or to a CRM if you prefer to do that. And that would happen through ideally creating a flow that just contains actions in it, no content, and then broadcasting that out to the people that you want to reach and actually get that information transferred over for. So I'll show you this method here and then I'll show you one more way. So if you click export PSIDs, this will just export all the PSIDs of the people that you have on your list right now. So pretty straightforward, that's all you're gonna get from it. And then what I just mentioned, which is adjusting a few things, I'll actually go ahead and do this inside of the Fletcher Goods account. If we go over to our automation, I'm just gonna say test broadcast. This is a way for you to get some more complex automation done for people on your list if you wanted to know a few things. So let's say that I wanted to send a bunch of information over to a Google Sheet. So I would create a sheet dedicated to this, and then I might call it, you know, test, or I'm just gonna grab this sheet here. And then I might wanna put in other information apart from this, but since I actually can't edit this Google Sheet that I am sending this to at the moment, I will just leave it there, but know that you can put as much information as you want. I would move the first step up there, delete that. We'll go ahead and publish this. And then if you jump over to the broadcasting tab and in the top right, click broadcast from flow, find the broadcast you just created, which by the way, ideally you would put into a specific folder and not just put into the wild so that it's left here in this crazy list of flows. But for right now, just to keep this simple and straightforward, I have left it this way. Okay, and the reason, by the way, that I created it in a flow and did not create it as a new broadcast from scratch is because even though this is very simple, if we had a lot more things happening here in this actions box, apart from Google Sheets actions, that I might want to reuse in the future or reference, I would create that in the flow just so that I can reuse that flow as many times as I want, but then actually use that broadcast from flow feature to paste it all into here instead of building something in here, which is not going to be reusable. It'll just be a little bit more of a complicated process to get that information. Like if I were to add a bunch of stuff in here and then send it out, I wouldn't have direct access to this. I'd have to create a duplicate broadcast and then access the content from there. So just to be clear, our typical best practice is to create the content for the broadcast in its own flow, in the flows folder, ideally in a specific folder labeled something like broadcasts or something having to do with a specific campaign. And then I would come over to the broadcast tab and click broadcast workflow. Just keeps things more organized, but at the end of the day, do as you wish. So then finally from there, if you go into the settings, then I would just add specific targeting based on who I want to capture this information for. And that is another way that you can also export information about your audience. And this would be more of a one-time thing where you're like, oh, I wish we had all this information in one place. Let me go and quickly do that. But ideally, as you build your campaigns out and you have certain automation running where maybe lead forms are being filled out, and by lead forms, I mean a series of questions that people are answering to determine if they're a good lead for your business or not inside of a ManyChat flow, that would be one use case where you add a Google Sheets action and you are actually collecting that information as time goes on. There wouldn't necessarily be a point in time where you're like, okay, I need to get all this information now into a Google Sheet. That's gonna be a little bit messy, and you would rather be collecting that as it comes in, just to be clear. And that's exporting your contact list. So I'll see you in the next video.